The end is in sight for the Space Shuttle, while the future of SpaceX is looking bright. I'm Benjamin Higginbotham, and this is your SpacePod for December 13th, 2010. The big news this last week was that Space Exploration Technologies, or SpaceX, has become the first company in the world to have a spacecraft launch, orbit the Earth, re-enter our atmosphere, and be safely recovered. Until now, only three countries have been able to accomplish this: the US, Russia, and China. Now here's a quick review of the launch itself, just in case you missed it.
4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We have liftoff of the Falcon 9.
Stage 1.
Pitch kick. Falcon 9 has cleared the tower.
First stage engines and tanks, looking good.
Beginning gravity turn.
Telemetry to lock on both stages, power systems nominal.
First stage propulsion is nominal.
Guidance nominal. Vehicle's now supersonic.
While watching a Falcon 9 rocket take off from Slick 40 at the Cape Canaveral Air Force Station is a lot of fun, I think watching the Dragon module separate from the upper stage is even more exciting.
Dragon deploy verified.
Approximately 288 kilometer perigee, 301 kilometer apogee. Inclination 34.53 degrees.
This is just the beginning. The Dragon capsule still needs to have the photovoltaic cells or solar panels added for energy generation, and additional maneuvering and docking tests need to be completed before SpaceX will be able to start officially carrying out its cargo transportation contract with NASA under the Commercial Orbital Transportation Services, or COTS contract. Now, just as SpaceX is starting to spin up production, NASA is winding down the Space Shuttle program. Last week, the final three Space Shuttle main engines, or SSMEs, were installed in Atlantis for the Launch on Need mission and potential final flight of the Space Shuttle program, STS-135. Each engine is 14 feet long, weighs 6,700 pounds, and is 7.5 feet in diameter at the end of the nozzle. Now that things have settled down a bit over here, it's our hope that we'll resume our live show this Friday at 0200 hours Coordinated Universal Time. We'll have our Roku HD giveaway, where you can win a free Roku box, allowing you to watch Spacevidcast live on your HD TV. The only way to win is to watch live. And for those of you in the U.S., that'd be Thursday night at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time or 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We'll see you there.